Good afternoon, everyone. So welcome back. So today we are going to discuss expected questions from the chapter thermodynamics. So already we discussed the important concepts and everything about the thermodynamics and as well as thermochemistry. So if you have any doubt, once go through those videos. Now let us discuss the few important model and expected models for the NEET 2020 from the chapter thermodynamics. Okay, let us start. Go to the first question. A gas expands from 1.5 to 6.5 liters against a constant pressure of 0.5 atmospheres. And during this process, the gas also absorbs 100 joules of heat. Then the change in internal energy is. So here, this process is taking place against a constant external pressure. That is the first key point. Okay, why? Because the process which is taking place against a constant external pressure, what we call irreversible process. So it was confirmed that it is an irreversible process, and its external pressure is how much? 0.5 atmosphere. And during this process, the gas also absorbing. So it is absorbing some amount of energy. So this question is based upon first law of thermodynamics. According to first law, change in internal energy del U is equal to Q plus W. So this is the formula for the first law of thermodynamics. Okay, now he is asking delta U. And the Q value they given. What is that? Its system absorbing how much of amount of heat energy? 100 joules. And now we need to calculate the W. And it was confirmed that this is an irreversible process. So first let us calculate the W first. W irreversible process is equal to, what is the formula? External pressure into delta V. Minus P external into delta V. That is equal to minus P external into delta V means V2 minus V1. Okay, so just substitute, what is the external pressure? 0.5, and V2 is 6.5, and V1 is 1.5. Why? Because it is changing from 1.5 to 6.5 liters. So that is equal to total how much? It will become minus 2.5 liter atmosphere scale. Why? Because pressure in atmospheres, volume in liters. So this is a work done in liter atmospheres. We need to convert these units from liter atmospheres to joules. So we know that since 1 liter atmosphere is equal to 101.3 joules. Now you should remember this. 1 liter atmosphere is equal to how many joules? 101.3 joules. And one more thing. If it is 1 liter bar, okay, if the pressure is in expressed in bars, liter bar is equal to exactly 100 joules more. Just remember this conversion. So this is a liter atmosphere. So if you multiply this with 101.3, we will get the work done in joules. So W is equal to minus 2.5 into 101.3. So it will be around minus 253 joules approximately. So this is a work done reverse. Now work done we know, and the Q value we know. If we substitute, then delta U is equal to, what is the Q value? The system is absorbing. So Q value was plus. So plus 100 plus. But W is what? Minus value. So that is equal to minus 253. So that is equal to approximately minus 153 joules. The change in internal energy is minus 153 joules. So the option is third option. Okay, ma. So this is the question based on first law and also work done in irreversible process. Two concepts. As we move to the second question, ma. And after every question, after you read the question, you try to solve on your own by simply passing the video. Thereafter, you watch the video, solution video. Okay. So, okay. Let us go to the next one. For the reaction, ethene C2H4 on oxidation, that is in presence of 3 moles of oxygen, giving 2 moles of CO2 and 2 moles of H2O in liquids. where del U means delta H, delta U, change in internal energy, they given minus 1415 kilojoules, then delta H at 27 degrees. So he given delta H value and asking what, sorry, delta U value they given, and they are asking what delta H they are asking. So what is the relation? So this is the question based on which formula, delta H delta U relation. As we know, delta H is equal to delta U plus delta NgRT. Okay, so what is delta Ng? So that is delta Ng is equal to number of moles of gaseous products minus number of moles of gaseous reactants. So in this equation, what is the equation? Let us write C2H4, this is in gaseous state, plus 3O2 gives rise to 2CO2 gas plus 2H2O liquid. So what is the del Ng value here? Del Ng is equal to how many moles of gaseous products? Only 2. These 2 moles is a liquid state. So number of moles of gaseous products are 2. And number of moles of gaseous reactants 1 plus 3, 4. So where del Ng value was minus 2. Substitute del Ng value. Then delta H is equal to delta U value. How much they given? Minus 1415 kilojoules. So that is minus 1415 plus del Ng value was minus 2. And R value you take it in joules, but they give in kilojoules, no? You divide over with 1000. So that is 8.314 by 1000 into, what is the temperature, at what temperature? 27 degrees they ask. So the 27 means how many kelvins? 300 kelvins. Okay, so what I am doing, this 8.314 I am writing as 25 by 3. It will be easy to simplification. That is why. That is equal to minus 1415. So this value will be minus, plus into minus, minus. Remaining is what? Two zeros cancel. And 2 into this 8.314 I am writing as what? 25 by 3. So 25 by 3 into 10 into 3. 3 cancel. So 25 2s are 50. 50 by 10 means 5. So overall minus 1415 minus, so how much? 50 by 10. So it will be around 5. That is equal to minus 1420 kilojoules. Minus 1420 kilojoules. So the option is what? Second option is the correct option here. So this is a question based on delta H and delta U relation. As we know, delta H is equal to delta U plus delta NgRT. So if they given the equation, here, from this equation we concluded that del Ng value was minus 2. Okay, and just substitute the value, del Ng value, R value and a temperature value, and if you substitute, finally the delta H value peak out. 1 mole of ideal gas expanding freely, underline this question, expanding freely, free expansion, okay, at 310 kelvins from 5 liters to 10 liters, 10 liters volume, then delta E and delta H respectively. That is the question. Okay, so no need to look after that. They're given clearly free expansion. If the reaction, the process is a free expansion, the work done, so and the work done is what? In a free expansion, zero. W value was zero. And he mentioned that at a constant temperature, 310 kelvins he mentioned, at a particular temperature, that means it is an isothermal process. For isothermal process, delta T value is equal to 0. If delta T value is equal to delta is equal to 0, then delta U is also equal to 0. Okay, then work done becomes 0, then automatically delta H value also becoming 0. So let us see. So here how we are solving for free expansion. For free expansion, from the free expansion we confirm that W value is equal to 0. Next one, at how much? 310 kelvins the process is going. This means, it means it confirmed it is an isothermal process. Isothermal process. If it is isothermal process, delta T value is equal to 0 and delta U value is equal to 0. Now delta U confirm, it is equal to 0. He is asking delta E and delta H. Delta E is already fixed. Confirm. Next, delta H. What is the relation? What is the relation between delta H and delta U? Delta H is equal to delta U plus del NGRT. Del NGRT is nothing but you can read as work. Okay, so delta H is equal to delta U value 0 and work done is also 0, that is equal to 0. So it confirmed that the both the values are what? 0 and 0. Clear? Next. Move to the next one, fourth question. The amount of work done by two moles of an ideal gas. How many moles? 2 moles of an ideal gas at 298 kelvins in a reversible isothermal expansion. He mentioned it is a reversible isothermal expansion. From where to where? From 10 liters to 20 liters. So what is the question he is asking? He is asking work done. Work done he is asking in a reversible isothermal process. And he may given number of moles. Okay. Work done in reversible isothermal. So what is the formula? So work done in reversible isothermal process is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1. Okay, that is the formula. Work done in reversible isothermal process is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1. So that is equal to minus 2.303. What is the n value? N means number of moles. How many moles he mentioned? He mentioned it is n 2 moles. So n value was 2. And r value, he given all options in joules. So r value, you take it in joules. That is 25 by 3. Okay. Then into temperature. What is the temperature? 298 into log V2 value. What is the final value? 10 to 20 means 20 by 10. 20 by 10. So if you simplify, minus 2.303 into 225 is a 50. 50 by 3 into, and 298 I am writing as 300 approximately. 298 approximately I am writing as 300 and log 2 value 0.3010 approximately I am writing as 0.3. Okay, now 3 ones are 300s. 100 into 0.3 it will be 30. Okay, so that is equal to minus 2.3 into 50, as you write it as this 50 as 100 by 2, no problem. And this will be 30. 2 ones are 2, 1.15. 1.15. So it will be, if you multiply 115 into 30, 115 threes are, so it will be 345 and 0, 3450 approximately, and it with a negative sign. Minus 3450 approximate value. What is the value nearest to this? Third option. Okay. So once again, amount of work done by 2 moles of an ideal gas at 298 kelvins in reversible isothermal, this is the key point, okay, from 10 to 20 liters is, so reversible isothermal work done is equal to minus 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1, and if you simplify, if you by substituting the values, and if you simplify, finally we are getting approximately 3400 joules of work done has finished. Fifth question. 5 moles of oxygen gas heated at a constant volume from 10 degrees to 20 degrees. Change of temperature from 10 to 20. Then the change in internal energy of the gas. Delta U value they are asking. And they are given Cp value and R value for reference. Okay. Now what is the relation which is between delta U and heat capacities. So change of internal energy, as we know, change of internal energy delta U is equal to N into Cv into delta T. N is number of moles, Cv is heat capacity at constant volume, and delta T is what? Change of temperature. So, but they are not given the Cv value, they are given Cp value. So, let us take the Mayer's equation. Cp minus Cv is equal to R, then Cv is equal to Cp minus R. What is the Cp value they are given? Cp value they are given in calories, that is 7.03. And R value, that is given in joules, but R value we know. What is R value in calories? 1.987. That is approximately equal to 2, you can take, no problem. So that is equal to 7 minus 03 minus 2 means 5.03. So approximately I am taking as what? 5. Okay. Cv value is how much? 5 I am taking approximately. So now change of internal energy delta U is equal to number of moles are how many? 5 moles. And the Cv value is also 5 moles, 5, and delta T value was 10. Why? Because 20 minus 10, 10. So 5 is 25, 25 times are 250. So delta value approximately 250 calories. That is equal to 252 calories. Okay, once again, he given the number of moles and they are given the reference values, that is Cp value and R value, and asking the value of change of internal energy. So, del U is equal to NCV delta T. First, you calculate the CV value and substitute the CV value in the final above equation. Finally, you will get delta U value. Heat capacity, molar heat capacity they are given. What do you mean the molar heat capacity? The amount of heat energy required to change the temperature of 1 mole of the substance by 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin Celsius, 1 Kelvin temperature is called what? Molar heat capacity. Now, the molar heat capacity of water is 75 joule Kelvin inverse, molar heat capacity. What is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 100 grams of water from 300 Kelvins to 302.4 Kelvins? Okay, so this is also the formula question based upon the heat capacities only. Okay, but he given what mass of the substance they given, and he is asking what amount of heat energy required. Okay, so what is the relation between heat energy release required and heat capacity and change of temperature? So we know the formula, that is what Q is equal to. Okay, Q is equal to N Cm delta T, same formula. Okay, where delta U is equal to NCV delta T we have written, delta H is equal to NCP delta T. Now heat capacity Q is equal to N into Cm means what? Molar heat capacity into delta T, that is equal to N value. What is N here? Number of moles. But have they given a number of moles in the equation in the question? No, they given what? Mass of the substance they given. Once we know the mass and the substance, we can calculate the number of moles, right? What is the formula? Number of moles is equal to given weight by molecular weight. So N is equal to 100 by, what is the molecular weight of water? 80, into molar heat capacity value, how much they given? 75 joules they mentioned, and delta T value from 300 to 302.4, that is equal to 2.4. Okay, so just to substitute the values, how much will come? 10 into 75 into 24 by 80, 63 za, 64 za, 3 2 za, 25 za. Okay, 250 4 za, 1000. So approximately how much of energy required? 1000 joules of energy required to raise the temperature from 300 to 302.4 Kelvins. Clear? Okay, next move to the seventh question. Seventh one. What he is asking, what they given? First, let us see. For the reaction at 1240 Kelvins, so what is the temperature? 1240 Kelvins, and the pressure is 1 atmosphere. The decomposition of CaCO3 has delta H value. So CaCO3 decomposition, and whose delta H value they given, that is equal to 176 kilojoule per kg. Then delta U is equal to, so delta H they given, delta U they are asking, same relation. So let us see. So seventh one, Ca, first write the equation, CaCO3 solid. On heating it decomposes to CaO solid plus CO2 gas. As we know, this is the decomposition reaction of CaCO3, where del Ng value is how much? Del Ng value is equal to 1. Why? Because solids we should not take, only gases only should take, 1 minus 0, that is equal to 1. So he's asking what delta H. So delta H value they given, delta U he's asking. So delta H is equal to delta U plus del Ng RT. Then delta U is equal to delta H minus del Ng RT. That is equal, what is the delta H value they given? 176 kilojoule. So that is equal to 176 into 10 cube minus. Okay, del Ng value how much? 1. And the R value, so this is in kilojoules. So now joules, you can take the R value in joules. And the temperature is how much? 1240. So R value in joules, that is 8.3 into temperature 1214. Okay, so if you simplify, so it should be less than 176 kilojoules. Here all the, these two options are less than 176. So if you want to exactly, you can calculate, no problem, solve that. If you substitute the values, R value and the temperature value, so final answer 165.6 kilojoules will come. So 165.6 kilojoules. Okay. The heat of formation of H2O liquid. Okay, enthalpy of formation they given. Heat of formation of H2O liquid is minus 286.2 kilojoules. Then the heat of formation of H2O gas is, so I think no need to solve also. Theoretically we can describe. See, the heat of formation of liquid water. So what is the standard physical state of water? Liquid state. So in that standard physical state, it is liberating how much of energy? 286.2 kilojoules. Then the heat of formation of H2O gas is, so it should be less than 286 or greater than 286. So if you understand that, then you can easily see, for formation of H2O liquid, while the formation of 1 mole of H2O liquid, it is liberating 286.2 kilojoules. But to convert that liquid water into gaseous water, it consumes some amount of energy. That is what we call it as vaporization. So that is always be endothermic. So out of this 286.2 kilojoules, some part of the energy it will consume for the conversion of liquid to gas. So that means it should be less than 286.2. In the options, which option is minus, less than 286? That is 242. So definitely the fourth option is the right option. Okay, so this is the logical question, in fact no need to solve. So once again, the heat of formation of liquid water is 286. Then the heat of formation of gaseous water, okay, then definitely it should be less than the given value, that is always be 242. Next, we move to the next one, ninth question. If standard enthalpy of formation for H2O2 and H2O are minus 188 and minus 286 kilojoule per mole respectively, then what will be the enthalpy change for the given equation? He has given an equation, he is asking enthalpy change of the reaction by giving, what is that enthalpy of formations? So by giving the formation enthalpies, and if they are asking the enthalpy of reaction, we have a simple formula. What is that? Sum of formation enthalpies of products minus sum of formation enthalpies of reactants. Okay, first let us write the equation. What is the equation they given? That is 2H2O2 gives rise to 2H2O plus O2. Okay, that is the equation they given. So in that equation, write the equation, that is it. Enthalpy change of the reaction, delta HR is equal to sum of standard enthalpy of formation of products minus sum of standard enthalpy change of enthalpy of reactants, products minus reactants. That is equal, in the given equation, what are the products? H2O and O2. So H2O in liquid state, O2 is a gas state. When the elements are in their standard physical states, what is the enthalpy? Zero. Okay, so then 2 into, what is the formation enthalpy of H2O in the equation they given? Minus 286. 2 into minus 286 plus 0. Why? Because oxygen is elemental form. So minus, now only one reactant is there, that is H2O2. How many moles are there? 2 are there. So that is why 2 into, what is the formation enthalpy of H2O2? Minus 188. Okay, so that is equal to 2 into minus 286, minus of minus plus 2 into 188. That is equal to 286 2s are 28 2s are 56, 572. 572 plus, okay, 190 2s are 380, means 376 will come. Minus 572 plus 376. So it will be definitely a negative value will come. 12 minus 6, 6, and 16 minus 7, 9, 1, minus 196, it is in kilojoule per mole. So what is the option? Minus 196 kilojoule per mole means first option will come. So once again, they given the formation enthalpies of reactants and products and asking the enthalpy of the reaction by giving an equation. Okay, simple formula, enthalpy of reaction is equal to formation enthalpies of products minus reactants, and if you substitute the value, finally we got the enthalpy of. Next, move to the 10th question. They given AB, A2 and B2 are the diatomic molecules. Three molecules they given, AB molecule, A2 molecule and B2 molecule. If the bond enthalpies of A2, AB, B2 are in the ratio of, so they given ratio of their bond energies, A2, AB, B2, that is 1:1:0.5 ratio, then an enthalpy of formation of AB from A2 and B2 also, they give an enthalpy of formation of AB, that is -100, then what is the bond energy of A2? He is asking bond energy of A2, that means he given, he is asking indirectly enthalpy of the reaction and the bond energy relation. Okay, first of all, formation of AB from A2, B2 mole. Let us write the equation for that. That is A2 plus B2 gives rise to 2AB. Okay, where delta H is equal to formation enthalpy of AB. How much they given? Formation enthalpy of AB, 1 mole of AB is equal to 100. But here how many moles are produced? 2 moles are produced. So definitely it should be what? 200 kilojoules. A2 plus B2 gives rise to 2AB, where enthalpy change is equal to minus 200, because here 2 moles of AB was formed. Okay, next. This is the enthalpy of formation of AB. This is nothing but enthalpy of reaction. What is the relation to enthalpy of reaction and bond energy? We know that enthalpy of reaction is equal to sum of bond energies of all reactants minus sum of bond energies of all products. That is equal to, what is the bond energies of here? A2, B2, AB ratio, they given bond energy ratio. What is that? A2 is to B2 is to AB. What is that ratio? A2 is 1:2 and B2 is 0.5:1. 1:0.5:1. And considering it, this is the X I consider. So that is A2:B2:AB is equal to X:X/2:X. Like that I consider. Okay, now. So what is this meaning? Bond energy of A2 is X. Bond energy of B2 is X/2. Bond energy of AB is X. Okay, now use these bond energies and substitute in the above equation. What is the enthalpy of reaction? Minus 200. So minus 200 is equal to, here reactants are 2 are there. So A2 is how much? A2 is X plus. B2 is how much? B2 is X/2. X plus X/2 minus 2 into, what is the bond energy of AB? X, 2X. Okay, that is X plus 0.5x minus 2x is equal to minus 200. Then 1 plus 0 by 1.5 minus 2, that means minus 0.5x is equal to minus 200. Minus minus cancel. then x is equal to 200 by 0.5, that is equal to 400 what is option, kilojoule per mole, 400 kilojoule per mole. So the option is fourth option. So once again, it is given three molecules A2, B2 and AB, and their bone energies ratio are 1:1:0.5, like this they are given a specific ratio, and enthalpy of formation of AB they given. Formation enthalpy means the change in enthalpy during the formation of 1 mole. Okay, for during the formation of 1 mole of AB, how much? It liberates 100 kilojoule. But here how many moles are produced? 2 moles are produced. That is why I just double that. 100 becomes what? 200 minus 200 kilojoules. What is the bond energy of A2? So this is the way. First of all, relation. And thereafter, I consider 1:1:0.5 as x is to x by 2. The sum of all both will get 200, so that x value we calculate 400 kilojoule per mole, where x is equal to what? X is nothing but the bond energy of A2 is asking that one. Clear? Right. The enthalpy of combustion of carbon and carbon monoxide are -390 and -278 kilojoule per mole respectively. Combustion enthalpy is they given. The enthalpy of formation of CO is, okay, so combustion enthalpy is, right, let us write the combustion equation. C plus 2C plus O2 gives rise to 2CO. Okay, that is the combustion of carbon graphite or diamond, whatever it may be. Combustion of reaction of carbon to carbon monoxide. Okay, now combustion enthalpy of carbon they given and carbon monoxide also they given, and formation enthalpy of CO they are asking. Formation enthalpy of CO. So let us first you calculate the total enthalpy change, enthalpy of reaction you calculate. Here enthalpy of reaction is equal to, enthalpy of reaction is equal to 2 times of enthalpy of formation of CO. Why? Because 2 moles produced, no? So then enthalpy of formation of CO is equal to half of enthalpy of reaction. So that is why first you calculate what? Enthalpy of reaction. What is the enthalpy of reaction formula? Enthalpy of reaction is equal to, if they given the combustion enthalpies, what is the formula? That is sigma of delta H combustion, combustion enthalpies of reactants, minus sigma of enthalpy of combustion of products, reactants minus products. Here only reactants are the two carbons and oxygen, but oxygen enthalpy was zero. Why? Because it's an elemental form. So carbon, how much they given? Enthalpy of combustion of carbon is 390 given. So 2 × −390. Why? Because 2 moles of carbon they considered. So reactants minus products 2 moles. 2 × what is the combustion enthalpy of carbon monoxide? That is −278. Combustion enthalpies of reactants minus combustion enthalpies of products. That is equal to 392, sir. So that is equal to 780 minus 780 minus of minus plus 278 2s are 282 are 560. So that means 556 will come. 556. If you subtract, minus value will come. 10 minus 6 4. Then 7 minus 5 2. And 7 minus 5 to 224 kilojoule per mole. This is the enthalpy of reaction. But what is that? Enthalpy of reaction is two times of formation enthalpy of carbon monoxide. So formation enthalpy of carbon monoxide, half of this. So therefore, formation enthalpy of carbon monoxide is equal to half of enthalpy of reaction, that is 224, that is equal to −112 kilojoule per mole. So what is the option? −112 means third option. See here, sign also very important. Why? Because the +112 they given, −112 given. So negative sign and positive sign, that is also very important. Next one, zinc solid copper plus 2 aqueous copper ion solution giving copper solid plus xenon plus 2 aqueous. This is one of the redox reaction. Why? Because zinc is undergoing oxidation, copper ion is undergoing reduction. Okay, given that standard Gibbs energy change of formation of Cu plus 2. Gibbs energy change of Cu plus 2 they given. And also Zn plus 2 also they given. So Cu plus 2 is 65 and Zn plus 2 is minus 147.2 kilojoule. Then the standard Gibbs energy change for the above reaction. So Cu plus 2 they given, Zn plus 2 they given. Total change in Gibbs energy for the above reaction they are asking. Okay, let us write the first equation. That is, what is that? Zn solid plus Cu plus 2 aqueous gives rise to Zn plus 2 aqueous plus Cu solid. That is the equation. When the element is in a pure solid or pure liquid form, their Gibbs energy value was 0. Here it is 0 and it is also 0. So what is the change in Gibbs energy? Del G is equal to sum of Gibbs energies of products minus sum of Gibbs energies of reactants. Products minus reactants. Here what is the product here? Zn plus 2. What is the Zn plus 2 value they given? That is equal to first one is Cu plus 2, second one Zn plus minus 147.2 minus of minus. So this is plus 1. 65. So this is plus value only. Cu plus 2 value was plus only. So that is equal to minus 147.2 minus 65. Okay, so what is the total value? Total value minus 0.2. 7 plus 5, 12. 4 plus 6, 10. 1. Sorry, 2. 212.2 kilojoule per mole. So that is what? Third option. Okay, minus 212.2 kilojoule per mole. Once again, he given Gibbs energy change of Zn plus 2 value they given, Cu plus 2 value they given, asking during this reaction what is the total change of Gibbs energy. If they are asking the question, total change of Gibbs energy of the reaction, del Gr is equal to sum of Gibbs energies of products minus sum of Gibbs energies of reactants. Products minus reactants. So if you substitute the values, finally we get 212, minus 212.2 kilojoules. Okay, 13th question. What is the free energy change, del G value, when 1 mole of water, 1 mole of water at 100 degrees and 1 atmosphere is converted to steam at 100 degrees and 1 atmosphere pressure? I think it is also a logical question, no need to solve. So just think. Free energy change, not standard Gibbs energy change. He is asking what? Gibbs free energy change. Del G value they are asking. Free energy change when 1 mole of water at 100 degrees in 1 atmosphere is converted into steam. At 100 degrees Celsius, water, liquid water and gaseous water means steam, they both are at equilibrium. So at 100 degrees, H2O liquid is in equilibrium with a H2O gas. At equilibria, what is the del G value? Del G value was 0. No need to solve. Okay, what is the del G value? 0 calories. It's a logical question. Okay, next move to the next 14th question. The enthalpy change during the formation of 24.95 grams of hydrated copper sulfate from anhydrous copper sulfate. Okay, that means enthalpy of hydration value they are asking is. So they given the equation. See, copper sulfate plus 5H2O gives rise to copper sulfate plus copper sulfate dot 5H2O hydrated copper sulfate, where enthalpy of the reaction is what? 78.2 kilojoules, minus 78.2 kilojoules. He's asking what? What is the total enthalpy change when we are using exactly 24.9 to form 24.95 grams of hydrated copper sulfate? Okay, check the equation. In that equation, what are they given? So write the, I'm writing the equation here. CuSO4 plus 5H2O gives rise to CuSO4 dot 5H2O. Okay, this is what degree of enthalpy of hydration. Enthalpy of hydration. So delta H hydration, enthalpy of hydration is equal to how much they given? Enthalpy of hydration value -78.2 kilojoule per mole. That means during the formation of 1 mole of this compound, 1 mole of high grade copper sulfate, how much of energy it liberates? 78.2 kilojoules of energy it will liberate. That means 1 mole of compound, hydrated compound, liberates 78.2 kilojoules. 1 mole. What is the weight of 1 mole of hydrated copper sulfate? For our reference, they given molecular weight of copper sulfate, 159.5. Okay, but hydrated copper sulfate we want. In hydrated copper sulfate, how many water molecules are there? 5 water molecules. 518 is a 90. You add 90 to that. Okay, so 159.5 plus 90 means 249.5 will come. So to form 249.5 grams of the compound, how much of energy it liberates? 78.2 kilojoules of energy. During the formation of 249.5 grams, it is liberating 78.2 kilojoules. But he's asking the question is what? The enthalpy change during the formation of 24.95 grams. 24.95 grams liberates x kilojoules. Just cross multiply these two. Cross multiply, that is 249.5x is equal to -78.2 into 24.95 times a, that means that x is equal to -78.2 by 10, then x is equal to -7.82 kilojoules. So during the formation of 24.95 kilo grams of hydrated copper sulfate, how much of energy it liberates? -7.82 kilojoules of energy it will liberate. So the option is what? -7.82 means fourth option will come. Okay, next move to the 15th question. The lattice energy of solid NaCl, lattice energy they give it 180 kilocalories. Okay, lattice energy is 180 kilocalories. The dissolution of solid in water, dissolution of solid in water in the form of ions is endothermic to the extent of 1 kilocalories per mole. That means enthalpy of solution they give it. Okay, why? Because if you dissolve the solid in the liquid water, we get solution only. So the enthalpy of solution is how much? 1 kilocalorie per mole. If the hydration energy of Na plus and Cl minus are in the ratio of 6:5, he is not giving the hydration enthalpy, he given that values, hydration enthalpy of sodium and the chloride ions ratio, they given 6:5. Then what is the enthalpy of hydration of Na plus ion? Okay, he is asking enthalpy of hydration of Na plus ion. Let us see. First of all, enthalpy of solution formula I am writing. Enthalpy of solution is equal to enthalpy of lattice energy. Lattice energy is the sum of lattice energy plus hydration energy. We know that. Enthalpy of solution is equal to, or enthalpy of dissolution is equal to, this is the sum of lattice energy plus hydration energy. From that, enthalpy of solution, how much they dissolution? 1 kilocalorie they given already, 1 kilocalorie. And the lattice enthalpy also they given, how much they given? Lattice enthalpy of solid Na is 180 kilocalorie they given. From that, enthalpy of hydration is equal to, enthalpy of hydration is equal to enthalpy of solution minus enthalpy, lattice enthalpy. So if you substitute 1 minus 180, there is minus 179 kilocalories will come. Okay, that is what enthalpy of hydration. Okay, but enthalpy of hydration is the sum of both Na plus ion and Cl minus ion. So enthalpy of hydration of Na plus ion is equal to, okay, what is the ratio? 6:5, total is 11. Okay, out of 11, 6 parts are what? Na plus ion. So that is why enthalpy of hydration of Na plus ion is equal to 6/11. Understood ma? Why I am writing 6/11? Why? Because they are given 6:5. So number of parts of Na plus is 6, total parts is 11, 6 plus 5, 11. So 6 by 11 of, what is the total enthalpy of hydration? Minus 179. Okay, so then enthalpy of hydration of Na plus is equal to, how much will come? That is equal to minus 186. 108, 108 by 11, it will be 9.97.5 kilocalorie. So this is a 97.5. Same question, enthalpy of hydration of chloride ion, if they ask, what is that? Then 5 by 11 will come. 5 by 11 into minus 179. Clear? This is an it seems it's a big question, but the logic is very easy. If you clearly understand the question, it is very easy to solve. Okay. Next, move to the next question. The values of delta H and delta S for the given equation. Graphite carbon on reaction with the carbon dioxide, we are getting 2 moles of carbon monoxide or 170. This is the delta H value, and the delta S value also 170 joule per Kelvin. This is 170 kilojoule. Delta H value kilojoule, delta S value joule. Then this reaction will be spontaneous. At what temperature the reaction becomes spontaneous? Okay, delta H, del S and spontaneity. Spontaneity we can decide by del G value. So what is the relation between del G, del H and del S? So I am using del G format. Del G is equal to del H minus T delta S. Okay, now you do one thing. First, at what temperature the system becomes equilibrium? You find out the temperature. You know, the temperature, all the temperature above the temperature will become spontaneous. So, first, at equilibrium means del G value 0. So, 0 is equal to del H value, how much they are given? 170 kilojoule. So, 170 kilojoule minus T del S value 170. Okay, you bring this 170 T to this side, then T is equal to 170 thousands 170. So we will get 1000 kelvins. At 1000 kelvins, the system is at equilibrium. At 1000 Kelvin, the system is at equilibrium. If the temperature is above 1000, then the system becomes spontaneous. If the temperature is less than 1000, then the system becomes non-spontaneous. So, in the given options, which option is more than 1000? That is equal to 1110. Clear? So, you just calculate at what temperature the system becomes, will get into the equilibrium state. Once we get that, the temperatures all above the temperatures become the system process, the process becomes a spontaneous process. Next one, the enthalpy change for the reaction. 4H gas gives rise to 2H2, that means 4 hydrogen atoms, gaseous atoms combining and giving 2 moles of hydrogen molecules is minus 869.6 kilojoules. Then the dissociation energy of hydrogen-hydrogen bond is dissociation energy. So he is asking the dissociation energy, but the given is hydrogen atoms gives rise to formation energy is they given. For that, what I am doing, I am just reversing the equation. So, what is the equation first he given? So, that is 4 hydrogen atoms giving what? 2H2 molecule, where del H value is equal to what? Minus 869.6 kilojoules they given. I'm just reversing that. That is 2 hydrogen molecules gives 4 hydrogen gaseous atoms, where del H value for forward reaction, if it is negative, then for backward reaction becomes positive. So that is equal to plus 869.6 kilojoules. Okay now. So he is asking what the dissociation energy for HH bond is. This is for 2 moles. Then for 1 mole, that is H2 gives rise to 2 hydrogen gases. The del H is equal to half of this, that is a 869.6 by 2, that is equal to 4348 kilojoules. Okay, formation energy 434.8 kilojoules. So The dissociation energy, this is equal to plus 434.8 kilojoules. So what is the option? Plus 434.8 kilojoules, third option. That is only the question they are asking. So they given formation energies of 2 moles of hydrogen they given, but they are asking dissociation energy of HH bond. So that is the way how to solve. Then move to the next one. The enthalpy of fusion of water, delta HF they given, that is 1.435 kilocalorie per mole. Then the molar entropy change. So they given enthalpy of fusion. Now they are asking entropy change for the melting of ice at 0 degrees is. Okay, what is the relation to the enthalpy of fusion and entropy, entropy change? So what is that? So that is direct formula number. Delta S fusion, change in entropy of the fusion is equal to enthalpy of fusion by freezing temperature. Okay, that is equal to, what is the enthalpy of fusion? They give me 1.435 kilocalories. 1435 calories I am writing by freezing temperature 0 degrees. Now, 0 degrees means 273 kelvins. 1435 by 27, approximately 5.26 calorie per mole will come. Okay, so the option is third option. Okay, sometimes what happened? Change in entropy of the vaporization they may ask you by giving the enthalpy of vaporization. In that case, what is the formula? Entropy change of vaporization is equal to enthalpy change of vaporization by boiling temperature. Okay, na? So in these two formulas, any one model they may ask. Next, 19th one. For the reaction, X2O4 liquid gives rise to 2XO2 gas. So it's a dimer. Dimers are giving two molecules of products, where del U value they are given 2.1, del S value 20 calorie per Kelvin at 300 Kelvin, then del G value is, okay, del G value. So first of all, from this del U value, first you calculate del H value. Okay, let us write the equation here. X2O4, 19th question, X2O4 is a liquid or gas? Liquid. Gives rise to 2XO2 gas. From this equation, first you tell me del NG value 2, because 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. So what is the relation to del H and del U? Del H is equal to del U plus del NG RT. So that is equal to del U value, how much they given? 2.1 kilocalorie, that is 2.1 into 1000 plus del NG value 2. R value in calories you take, why? Because they given the options in calories only. So calories is 2. Okay, and the temperature is how much? 300 kelvins. That is equal to 2100 plus 43 is 1200. 2100 plus 1200, how much will come? 3300 calories will come. That is equal to 3.3 kilocalories. That is a del H value. But he is not asking the del H value, he is asking del G value. So del G is equal to del H minus T delta S. That is equal to, what is the del H value? 3.3, that is 3300 minus temperature 300, and del S value 20 calories. 20 calories. That is equal to 3300 minus 6000. So how much will be minus 2000? 700 calories will come, that is equal to minus 2.7 kilocalories. Minus 2.7 kilocalories means, so second option. Okay, so once again, you give an equation, X2O4 gives rise to 2XO2, del NG value 2. So from this equation, first you calculate the del H value from the del U. After you calculate the del H value, to calculate the del G value, we have a relation. Del G is equal to del H minus T delta S. And substitute the del H value in T delta S. Finally, we get del G value. No? A hypothetical reaction, A gives rise to 2B. A is giving 2B. Proceed through the following sequence of the steps. The first one, A is giving the C where del H value plus Q. C is giving D where del H value plus Q2. Half D gives rise to B where del H value Q3. Then the heat of the reaction will be, Okay, so we have a relation if the, okay, first let us write the data. What is the data he given?
So for 20th question,
he given A to C, A to C, where del H value is how much? Q1 plus Q1. Next, C to D, C to D, where del H value that is equal to plus Q2, and half D gives rise to B, where del H value is equal to Q3. This is the data. But he is asking, what is the equation? He is asking the equation that is A to 2B. A to 2B. To get this equation, we need to arrange this given equations. Okay, in the final equation, A is in the left hand side, B is in the right hand side, products side. Accordingly, you just arrange. So, I am writing the first equation as it is. A gives rise to C. Okay, first equation as it is, del H value is equal to plus Q1. Next, second equation also I am writing as it is, C to D, where del H is equal to plus Q2. But the third equation, I am writing, I am just doubling that. Why? Because in the products I said 2 moles of B is we need. So that is why I am just doubling that. If you double the third equation, 2 into 1 by 2 D. D gives rise to 2 moles of B, where del H is equal to 2 Q3. Del H value also we should multiply. So if you add all, okay, DD cancel, CC cancel. What is the net equation? A gives rise to 2B. Okay, then del H is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus 2Q3. Q1 plus Q2 plus 2Q3. Okay, so option is third option. Third option. So these are the top 20 questions in the chapter thermodynamics and thermochemistry. Okay, thank you.